Hello, I am Dr. Neelima Mishra from Parasite and Host Biology Group. I am working on operational research projects of national importance for the last 12-13 years. Under this, we have developed nationwide sentinel site system across country for monitoring the efficacy of anti-malarial medicines. These studies have led to policy change for the northeastern region in 2013, and also before that we were doing the prescription practices and drug use practices in the Jharkhand state after some of the studies, like the oral artemisinin monotherapy prescription across 6 states in the country, which led to policy change by a ban on sale of oral artemisinin monotherapy in the country in 2009. And under the nationwide sentinel site system, we have generated data on pharmacovigilance of antimalarials and also the monitoring of glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme deficiency in northeastern regions. And these type of studies have resulted in publication in Acta Tropica, where we have shown novel mutations in G6PD enzyme. Also, we have done studies on malaria prevention strategies, where intermittent screening and treatment of pregnant women has resulted in decline of malaria incidence as compared to the control group. In addition to these studies, we have also carried out mass surveys in northeastern states, and where we have seen that the prevalence of asymptomatic, or we can say the submicroscopic malaria, is quite high in the areas where we were thinking that the incidence of malaria is very low. So using all the 3 diagnostic techniques, that is screening by RDT, confirmation by microscopy, and then the final diagnosis using molecular technique, has helped us in detecting the high prevalence of submicroscopic malaria in these sites. Also, our group has developed a technology which is a novel diagnostic technique to differentiate the species of malaria parasite, which has resulted in Indian patent and commercialization approval by ICMR. And international patent is under filing. So, coming to the future plans, we are looking into developing diagnostic techniques for detection of submicroscopic malaria, where we can use the non-invasive biological samples like saliva, urine and other fluids, which can be used in the diagnosis of submicroscopic malaria. To conclude, the research group focuses on operational research projects leading to problem solving and decision making, ultimately benefiting the malaria affected population in the country.